Hey guys, so probably like the biggest political news story this year, and maybe even last year or something like that, but especially this year, has been Patient Protection and Affordable Care Act of 2010, also known as Obamacare. Obamacare, big thing, you know, it's been, that's why, like, that's a good reason why this country, the government shut down, or a good chunk, non-essential portion of the government was shut down for a long time because of the resistance to Obamacare. It's a big story. I haven't ever talked about it in this channel, and I'm finally making a video in which I do, and I share my thoughts on it. So now, you know, the big thing has been about, big debate or the big talk has been about the website. You know, it's a shoddy mess, and the president implemented, or the Congress, like, people implemented it without better planning, and it was just a messy release, and it was a rush release, whatever. So, poor job. President Obama actually had to even apologize. So, definitely the implementation of it has not been smooth. You know, we all know that and whatnot. But the resistance to it has been so fierce. You know, they tried to repeal it 46 times or something like that, and it's the resist, and it's still fierce. You know, it's such a huge thing, that this big deal, like, that it's gonna, like, oh my gosh, it's gonna take away our freedoms, gonna make United States into a socialist country, or Obamacare makes, you know, Obama into a Hitler, or this is like a Hitler policy, this makes the country fascist. There has been so many crazy rhetoric because of the resistance to Obamacare. And I understand that, I think. But I think it's time for those naysayers, you know, people who don't like Obamacare, they're going to have to accept it, because this is a really landmark legislation, and what's done is what's done. You know, Supreme Court made its decision. It's a really odd decision, the way it was argued this time around. It's more of a tax now, Obamacare. They had to do, like, it's an interesting thing how it happened, right? But it's here to stay. I think, you know, the website is horrible, but that's the implementation part. You know, as far as, like, the actual what Obamacare does, I think it's gonna have a pretty lasting impact on the country, and for better or worse, you might hate it. You might have benefited from it without even realizing it, or you might have actually been harmed by it. I think it's not gonna go away. And what does that mean? You know. So to me, I'm more of a leftist kind of guy. So Obamacare, like, I don't like it. You know, I don't like it because it doesn't do enough, and it doesn't do it in a way that's simple, whatever. But I kind of also think that, for this country, this was like the only possible thing that could have happened in this political climate, you know, the way that was done. This was a very bipartisan effort. If it was like one party doing it, Obamacare would not look like what it is right now. But it was a bipartisan effort. You know, like, the individual mandate that came from the Heritage Foundation, which is a conservative think tank, The way it's run, it's very similar to what Romney did in Massachusetts with the detailed care system. You know, if it was more socialist or a single payer system, it would look more like how it is now in Vermont, single payer Medicare for all. Well, Obamacare is not like that. It utilizes private insurance companies and this market exchange system. You know, it's a mishmash of government and private sector. So it's a mix of both, and that's kind of what's terrifying about Obamacare. It's like, in some ways, it's the worst of both worlds, you know? Private industry have no accountability at all, and they can get away with shit, and they don't have to serve everyone. Where government has to do that, and that's what makes them, a lot of times, inefficient and whatnot. So, my overall thoughts on Obamacare, I think, just in a direction, I think it's the right direction to go. It does do a lot of great things. I know maybe some of you guys who don't like Obamacare like will hear that statement and be like, what? There's a lot of great things? No way. So a couple of examples. You know, kids can now stay onto their parents' insurance plan until they're 26. And this is a big deal, you know, I think, because I have a friend who's 25 right now, and if Obamacare didn't happen, she would have no health insurance. But she's under her parents' plan, so she's 25, she has health insurance through her parents, and she's going to switch over to, insurance through her job. But it's much cheaper for her right now to be under her parents' plan, and it's a better plan. Because the insurance plan that her job offers is a crappy plan. So for things like that, I think it's great that and it's less burden on students who are gonna have, you know, high college tuition and living expenses and all that, and they're starting their workforce, you know, their work career. So the pay they're gonna get from starting work, it's not gonna be high, you know? So this is a great boost for economy for those people, you know, to encourage young people to start getting into the workforce, you know. So that's one great thing. It eliminates denying coverage based on pre-existing conditions, which I think is a really big deal. But this happened all before Obamacare was actually started being implemented on October 1st, you know. And I don't think a lot of people realize that the plan that are being dropped because of this Obamacare regulations and whatnot. Well, first, your plan was probably going to be canceled or dropped anyway. But even if not, second, your plan was probably awful. If it doesn't meet Obamacare standards or regulations, it probably doesn't really do much. So an example I can give is my dad's health insurance is with my mom. My mom's a nurse, so she has the health insurance through the hospital. Her insurance is amazing, right? But my dad is under my mom's insurance, and for the spouse, it's pretty crap. My dad went to the hospital to do some checkups, and the insurance pays for barely anything. Like, month after month, my dad's getting, like, bills. It's like, oh, yeah, we want, you know, you have to pay $200 for this exam, you have to pay $300 for this exam. It's like, what is the point of having insurance if he has to actually pay for all this because he used the hospital? He's paying for insurance, and he's paying for all this medical bills. Well, because the insurance doesn't pay for jack squat. You have insurance, but it's like, why do you even have insurance if it's not going to do anything? So a lot of the insurance that don't meet Obamacare guidelines are those types of really crappy insurance that really don't do much. And, you know, if you're going to do like an emergency visit anyway, which I guess the insurance would try to cover, like, you don't need an insurance for that, you know? So that's one thing, you know, and I guess the mix up is like this whole private, you know, sector. You could choose from the market exchange and whatnot. It's a weird picture. I think the way America does is healthcare, it's very odd. it's about health insurance and not actually health care. You know, you're not choosing who is your provider or what is your service like or what's the quality of your health service. You're choosing who is your insurer. So you're choosing the middleman who chooses who will provide money for you when you get healthcare. And it's like a pool of money that you put into so that most of the money will go to very few minority of people who have chronic illnesses and things like that. This is how the system is. So even if we had a socialist system like universal healthcare, it wouldn't look that different. The only big difference is that the middleman would not exist. Or if it does exist, it would exist in a much different fashion. The doctors would have more say in the pay or the money aspect than the insurance people, which is how this country is. So, I don't know. Obamacare does, I think it does a lot of great things, but the resistance to it has created a lot of problems. So one big example, of course, is the fact that, you know, Obamacare wanted to expand Medicaid to more people, like 200% above poverty level, you know, because Medicaid before that has usually just been below the poverty level. But by raising that, it increases the insurance coverage. But about 20 states or something, or much of them southern states, conservative states, like, have refused to accept government subsidy to expand Medicaid. So instead of expanding Medicaid, they're doing all kinds of different things. Tennessee is, I think, the strangest example, where they're doing, like, lottery. Like, people apply for Medicaid, and or call to apply to Medicaid, and they might get accepted or they might not, because it's a lottery system. They get a number, and it's crazy. Like, lottery on health insurance, seriously, that's like gambling on people's health and lives. But that's how Tennessee is doing it, because they refuse to expand Medicaid. And that really has to go with, like, state authority, because first federal authority, like, the state of Tennessee is like, you can't tell us what to do, how we can handle our healthcare. We're going to do it our own way, which I respect the state's right of that. But at the same time, like, that means that people in those states are going to suffer. And I guess the one alternative for those people to have better health insurance for poor people is to go to a different state. But then moving to a different state requires money. So they're going to be stuck there, you know. So that's one pretty awful aspect of Obamacare, like how it turned out. I do think the website thing is going to get ironed out. You know, I think it's going to give it time, and it's going to work better, I think. Because think about it, like, having a system that is so large in scope, that has such high demand, and having, like, even public, well, it was done by, like, private, you know, it was just, whole thing was done by the website aspect was done by the private sector. They hired companies and people in companies to do this. The tech geniuses or whatever. So, yes, government has a hand in it, but the people who actually did it is the private sector. So, this is a fumble of both, you know, public sector, the government, and the private industries. It's not just the government being crap, you know. In some ways, it is. But I think the website thing is not as big a deal as people make it out to be, because remember when Social Security Act was implemented, or when Medicaid started out, it was the implementation in the beginning was horrible. They didn't have websites; they were doing with pencil on paper, you know. And we have it now, whereas Medicaid and Medicare is what it is now. It's pretty amazing, you know. And Social Security is what it is now, so. I think Obamacare will eventually get to be like that. Like, it's going to be so established that if people were, like, thinking about, you know, repealing Obamacare, that would be heresy. Just like how cutting Social Security now, talking about that, you're not going to get elected to any, you know, political position by saying that I'm going to gut Social Security. Yeah, good luck trying to be a senator or the president after saying that, you know. So, ultimately, Obamacare is, I think, a step, tiny step in the right direction for me. But it's just, it does so little, you know, and it tries to compromise all these different conflicting ideologies about, you know, what the private sector should be doing, what the government should be doing, and what the insurance should be doing, and how we should promote capitalism and competition and treating healthcare as a commodity. So all these different ideas are jumbled together in this one 2,000-page legislation. And this is what we have, you know. It's messy, it's crazy, it gets a lot of criticism, and it is deservedly so. It should get that amount of flack and that amount of criticism, but the only thing is, the resistance towards it is like, let's remove it altogether. Well, no, because status quo before Obamacare was crap. Obamacare is better than the former status quo. That is my opinion. You might disagree with that, but it is. But the way towards it really has to be one way or the other. It really has to be just kind of much more, everything is pretty much done by the private sector. And I wouldn't agree with that, but that's one way to do it. Or a universal healthcare system like how it is in many Western countries, like France and Germany. would be great. But this middle ground that we have with Obamacare, it fixes some of the problem. It causes some of the problems. But we're going to have to move beyond this. I think, but this is a step that was taken. And, you know, there's no changing that fact. We can't go back now. We can only move whatever way, direction. But this point before Obamacare is done. That's history. So, you know, I have a fear that the next budget negotiations, maybe government is going to get shut down again over trying to repeal Obamacare or something like that. I have no idea. Or, you know, people trying to defund Obamacare, and that's what worries me again the next time budget negotiations happen. I hope the opposition realizes that, you know, it's kind of futile to have a battle about Obamacare at this point. The better fight is to, well, now what do we do? Now how can we make this healthcare system in America better? And so I would rather, you know, I don't know, politicians are what they are, you know, they're what they are. But it would be my wish to see them have that kind of debate rather than this really infantile debate they've been having recently about this stuff, you know. But those are my thoughts. I don't know how you feel about them, but share your thoughts to me if you would like in the comment section below. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Cheers.